Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, and today I'm doing a video on the new moon update, and it is obviously a solar eclipse, something that I think we've all been looking forward to, especially when it's in, you know, nice reliable Taurus, and the moon will be at 10 degrees on the 30th to the 1st of May, depending on where you are in the world. It's on the 1st of May for me because I'm in Australia. Obviously, it being a solar eclipse is a really good time, you know, for a fresh start. It's got even more potency. A solar eclipse energy usually lasts, like, you know, a much longer time. And the last time we actually had this particular angle of a solar eclipse in Taurus at this degree was back in 2014. So if you can look, if you can remember what you were doing in 2014 around that time, I totally can't, but I do remember it being a transformational year, just with kind of growing up and everything, kind of like, you know, in my teenage years and stuff. And, you know, having to make some pretty, the sort of stern changes, because obviously, you know, Taurus, the bull, we do have that stubbornness. And, you know, it's kind of like rules, like our values, you know, think second house kind of stuff. Our values and, like, you know, what we kind of really, how we really want to, like, spend our time, you know, things that we might really want to invest our time in, our self-confidence, our self-worth, how we feel about ourselves on an emotional sort of inner level is sort of second house kind of stuff. It's a self-confidence house. It really is. And can be a slight materialistic house, like what, you know, if we value things, then the second house can be super materialistic because, you know, it is ruled by Taurus. Things as in, like, you know, just nice bed sheets or like a fancy car, like, you know, it can get, Taurus can get a little bit towards the materialistic side. I also do believe that Taurus is all about nice smells and things like that. So maybe you might buy a really nice perfume and, like, it's going to be something that you're going to use just like forever. It could just be something as simple as that. But with a solar eclipse, I feel like it's never as simple as that. It's probably going to be something more than that, especially because we have Uranus just in 4 degrees behind the sun and the moon, which is gonna, I think, create a lot more change. We're definitely gonna feel that energy, even though it is a 4 degree split. I really do go off a 5 degree split. It's still gonna feel that energy with the outer planet. So, you know, and we do have the true node in Gemini also not far behind at 22 degrees as well. So, you know, I really do feel like they're all kind of hanging out still pretty close together, Uranus especially. So we're going to notice change, we're going to notice impact. We might make strong changes at this time and stick to them. This is a great time to make strong changes and stick to them. If you have something, you know, if you've noticed that, you know, you're not really treating yourself so well, treating other people so well, and you want to change that about yourself, or maybe you want to quit smoking or something like that, like, this is a really good time to kind of step into what you value and what you, or what you want to value that you haven't started valuing in your life yet. So, you know, that's, it's a really, really potent time to make some changes. Don't waste it, you know. It's a really, I think personally, well aspected solar eclipse. You know, the moon's making some really, and the sun are making some really nice energy towards Mars, which is like a nice little release, giving us a little bit of energy, a little bit of boost to kind of, you know, enjoy, hopefully, the weekend as well, because, you know, it is heading into the weekend. And just give us the energy to make the changes that we want to make, or see the people that we want to see, or do some things around the house, create new habits that we want to hang around for a while, or, you know, take that next step in a relationship, like all that kind of stuff, like, comes into play here. Look to where Taurus is in your house and you can kind of figure out, you know, how that might play out for you. Also the Venus conjuncting Jupiter, you know, love is going to be very expansive energy here because, you know, Taurus is genuinely ruled by Venus. So we have a Venus conjuncting Jupiter at the moment as well. And that is in Pisces. Everybody loves that energy. It's at 27 degrees. So, you know, when it's sort of towards the end of a zodiac sign, that tends to have a bit more of a boost as well. And Jupiter is expansive energy on Venus. So there's just going to be a lot of loving, I reckon. Or we could go a little bit overboard with some stuff. But I genuinely just think we're going to be, like, having a good time. So I wouldn't worry about it too much. I mean, it is going to be like pretty good explosive energy, super good time for creatives. I mean, I love Pisces energy for creating things, and Taurus as well, ruled by Venus. You know, art is a great time. Maybe you have an exhibition that you've been waiting forever to go to, or maybe you are holding your own exhibition. So all these kind of things. Awesome time to go to an event this weekend. You'll probably have a total blast. You might just spend a little bit too much money here and there. That could be like a possibility. But also a really nice weekend. Taurus loves to sit at home and relax and indulge as well. So, you know, it could be just like, you know, long weekend, last weekend, I want to sit at home this weekend and just enjoy myself. And, you know, I want to stay home and I want to save and I want to make those like really good changes in my life. I want to stop kind of going out. Like that could be, you know, a massive thing, like especially, you know, in Western culture society, I think we all kind of get a bit stuck into consumerism and materialism and all that sort of stuff. So, I mean, I know personally that I struggle with that. But everything's really nice, you know, like if I'm just looking at kind of like the major aspects, the only thing that kind of really stands out to me, like negatively, is just kind of like a slight bit of negative energy coming from Saturn in Aquarius. So, I don't know, Aquarians might feel, especially if, you know, you have anything around the 24 degree of Aquarius, you might feel a little bit of like a hit, a little bit more tension when it comes to this solar eclipse. And you know, I think everyone feels the energy of a solar eclipse because, you know, we all have areas and houses, like even if our planets are making no aspects to any of it, I think we all still kind of feel it anyway. But yeah, I mean, Saturn's just giving off a little bit of a meh kind of vibe, but we always need negative aspects to give us a little bit of a push. So I don't think, you know, it's the end of the world. Saturn's probably just saying like, hey, it's not all perfect. Because if it was all perfect, to be honest, this solar eclipse would probably be pretty boring. So we need Saturn's our taskmaster to kind of like come back in there and be like, hey man, you know, this shit needs to get done. Like if you have got paperwork that you haven't done for a while, like this is the time, do it. I'm sure we've all been listening to like the Johnny Depp Amber Heard court case, and I'm sure they'll be loving this weekend. Maybe they'll be gathering some new information, the both of them, to attack at each other. But we'll see what happens. And it's a really good time to make changes, even though Saturn is negatively aspected. I just think overall it's a positive chart. I just think the Venus conjunct Jupiter, we might get a little bit too excited and maybe take things a little bit too far here or there sometimes, but it's such a soft energy in Pisces. I just don't see that really happening too much. But yeah, again, Saturn giving us a little bit of a, hey now, you know, let's get some things done that we haven't done for a while, because Taurus really is about our serious values. Taurus is like, you know, it gives me like that mum energy, like, you know, those mums that just like get so much stuff done, like they're so practical, their house is clean, their children are perfect, like, and everything is just done and good and organized. Like, I don't know, like Taurus just like gives me that awesome, nurturing, loving, clean mum energy. Like, I don't know why, but like it just does. I've just met so many Tauruses that are just like, even when they're like big strong men and they're like carpenters, they just give me that like nurturing mom energy. I don't know why, but it's just the thing. So channel that mom energy during this solar eclipse. Get the things done, get your paperwork sorted, make changes for the future, you know, like solar eclipse energies, you know, they usually kind of like give us a nice 6 month energy. So get onto it, get it done, don't waste the time, and you know, enjoy it. All right, I'm gonna leave it there. I feel like I just blabbed on like so fast and so much because I just finished work and I'm like just so ready to have dinner. Like right now I'm starving. Anyway, I will be getting back to obviously my Ascendant Rising series and some other series that I want to start. I haven't been posting. I've been sticking to my Moon series because I've epically failed it in the past, but I'm sticking to it this time. But I have just not had a lot of time lately, but I am still making time for these. So I'm But there will be more videos coming and more good content. Okay, I'll leave it there because I need to shut up now. All right, bye.